Hey guys, welcome back. Today I have something totally different for you. Today I'm going to take you along on an overnight backpacking trip. Hey guys, welcome back. Glad you could join me today. Today's going to be a little different. I'm going to show you some of my out-of-doors activities. It's a bit of a departure for this channel. You guys have never seen these probably on my channel, but hope to share a few things with you. I'm going to try and videotape this the best I can, hopefully a little better than right now as I'm walking down a pretty steep hill, but really looking forward to this, guys. I'm hiking down into the river valley here in my local town, hike upstream a little bit. We're going to break camp for the night, or make camp for the night, and hopefully we'll have a little bit of fun. So I'll show you some of the gear and some of the activities, and this is where we're headed right now. Pretty cool. If you guys didn't already see it, I'll put a link on the screen here to my packing video of this backpack and all the gear that I take with me on these short overnight hikes. And yeah, if you find it interesting, check it out. Everything's listed there except for the camera equipment I brought to videotape this stuff with you. Well guys, this is going to be camp for the night. This is the exact same spot I camped in 2 years ago. It's pretty close to town, but it's a little sheltered from both sides from people. The ground is not real good, but we had a lot of rain in the last couple of days. The river's up way high, but forecast is clear for the next 3 days, so shouldn't be any more water coming down. If I start swimming in the middle of the night, well, I'll just have to move. It's the way it's gonna be. But this is it, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and start getting set up. First order of business, guys, we're going to get some water on the go. The light's going to dwindle pretty quickly down in the river valley here pretty deep, so even though it's barely supper time, we're going to have a little less light than we want pretty quickly. So let's get this out. Guys, in the pack, we've got some basic contents. Hopefully they don't blow away too much here. Platypus bag. Another platypus bag. We're gonna put our fresh water in there. The filter itself. This is the MSR Sweetwater. I don't think you can buy these anymore. They were discontinued a long time ago, actually, which is kind of a shame because this was a really good piece of kit. This thing has served me extremely well. You can reuse them for basically indefinitely. Comes with a filter brush to brush out the filter, and then you back flush it and away you go again. As long as you clean them out real good at the end of the trip. Some people store them in the freezer. I just dry mine out really well. I haven't had a problem yet. Try not to get our lines too gunked up here. This is going to be our suction line. I'm going to take this, insert it onto the bottom. We're gonna hope this thing works because it's been a while since I used it. I tried the pump last night. Pump worked good. Made sure I gave the filter a little clean out just from being in storage. As a float, take a rubber band off of the platypus bag. These are just coffee filters, guys. You don't need to do this. I prefer to because I'd rather a coffee filter gets gunked up than my inlet strainer. And I seem to have no problems with it getting plugged. It actually works really well. So you just take this, stick it around the end there, and you can just put a rubber band on. We don't need a good seal because this thing isn't necessary anyway. It's just nice to have. Take your cap off, thread onto the end of our platypus bag here. Take our outline off the pump into the nice little cap. Not going to put it on yet because we're going to draw a little bit through it. And keep our, use our float to keep it up off the bottom a bit. It's really shallow here. Not a very good demo spot. This thing works so good, I'm not worried about silt. And that's, we also have our filter on there, so we don't have to worry too much about silt. And there we go. We're making water, guys. Stick that on. And we pump away until we fill our bags. Nothing to it. It's going to take a while. So I'm going to shut the video down here and resume once I get these filled up. So I'm just going to finish off by filling my my bottle here. What we've already got is two fresh, clean bags for drinking water. This stuff is perfectly safe. These filters filter out all the little nasties and microbes and everything, with the exception of viruses, but there's not much for viruses in the water around here. Just a lot of other nasties that you don't want to drink, like cryptosporidium and other nasties. Forget all the names of them. Truthfully, I don't worry about them too much anymore. Should mention there's a couple safety features on this, at least one main one. Right here is a discharge. Should the filter become too clogged to pass through, your pumping will discharge here and not contaminate your clean water. That's really crucial, guys. Also, storage wise, I'll be using this again. I might not. This might be enough water to do me till tomorrow. But if you, in the interim, when you set it aside, don't contaminate your clean line with your dirty line. One last thing to mention about this filter, it's double acting. So it takes half the time to pump the water as some of the really ultra cheap units. I don't know whether you can still buy this particular unit. If I could, I'd buy another one in a heartbeat. This thing has just served me super well, guys. No complaints. I do take care of it, though, and like I showed you, the extra filtration and stuff to prolong the life of my filter element in here. It is a stone filter element, as far as I remember. It's not really changeable. It comes as a unit, but if it's maintained, you'll never need to. So guys, this is the ThermaRest I showed you in my packing video. Hopefully I'm getting this in frame. We've got the tent set up now. Looking pretty good. Other than what we're sitting on is solid rock. But we can live with that. I set up just over a little grassy portion in the middle here. Go ahead and get this thing out. Guys, if you're not familiar with these, this is a self-inflating mat. Weighs very, very little. We'll open the valve on this, spread it out, and we'll just leave it to do its thing for a while. Guys, this is the beauty of living in Canada. I am only about 3 kilometers from my house over there. Go a few kilometers in any direction and you get beauty like this. I have to say I'm pretty happy to live here. So let's get our sleeping arrangements sorted out, because, well, that's why we're here for later. We're going to need to sleep. The ThermaRest has had a little bit of time to inflate. It hasn't fully inflated. It has been in storage a long time. So we're going to have to give it some breaths and blow this thing up. That's it, guys. Don't want it too overly inflated. This does not look like much. I assure you, these things are one of the most comfortable mats you'll sleep on. They have some even nicer series yet that I'd like to get, but maybe I'll email somebody and see if they want to let me do a review on one. But for my use, I like this one. It served me well. Thankfully, guys, I made that video of my pack contents, and when I was editing it, which you're going to be viewing, actually, I can't remember whether it goes live when I'm out here or not, but I realized I packed the wrong bag. Packed my fiance's bag. So what I have here is the Pack Light rectangle bag. It's not a mummy bag. It's full on rectangle. This is what we're going to be using tonight. I can't remember the rating on this bag. I think it's down to 0C, but I found it to be significantly warmer than what I need in this kind of weather. We're gonna find out though. We'll give it a go. This is the Kelty Mesa 2 tent. It's got some pockets in the corners, here and here and here, lots of room for storing goodies. And we're just gonna set everything aside and go on to the next task. Well guys, I did bring a couple of creature comforts from home. I think it's time that we get some firewood. So I got some wood, guys. It's just driftwood that I collected along the river. Pretty much no environmental impact to this, other than we're gonna have to make sure we clean up our ashes. But this is all just deadfall, dead limbs, stuff that's just laying around. So that should be more than enough to last us the night. Well guys, I'm really enjoying this now. Got our firewood lined up, tent set up, sleeping arrangements are set up. I just have to decide where I'm gonna make the fire. Wind's coming from the west pretty good, so usually I have my fire right here, but I think we're gonna have to make it downwind of the tent this time. I broke out the KD radio. Perhaps we'll do some tuning around. Guys, these radios are fantastic. I can't say enough about them. I've seen other reviews online that knock them, pieces of junk, whatever. For a backpack radio with shortwave capability, man, I love these things. So maybe a little later we'll fire it up and this is my unwind time, guys. I really, really enjoy this. This is heaven for me. I most probably don't know that I am far more comfortable in the bush than in the technology that I play with on my YouTube channel all the time. I have to say, I grew up in the bush a lot as a young child, and it's where I've always been happiest. I'm actually pretty proficient in bushcraft, believe it or not. I haven't wandered out into the bush with nothing lately, but I'm pretty sure my skill set would still serve me well. Spent many a night off by myself, just touring into camping in new areas and checking things out. So, well guys, it's time to get some supper on the go, I think. What I brought was an MRE, a meal ready to eat. I've never used one of these before out camping. I mentioned in the packing video they simply weigh too much. I brought some backup stuff too for lunch tomorrow, breakfast, whatever. So we're gonna give this a go. These have a heater built in, and this one is penne with vegetable sausage, potato and cheddar soup, and a spoon. So it's a really basic one. It's from Meal Kit Supply Canada. It's not as extravagant as a like a US military one. I have some of those style as well in my emergency supplies I keep in the basement. But let's go ahead and get into this thing and we'll give it a go. See if we can get this fired up. It's been a long time since I even used one of these Meal Kit Supply ones, so it's gonna be a bit of a learning experience, guys. In the package, we have our penne, a spoon. It's actually a really nice quality spoon, so I don't even have to break out my fork. This should be the soup, and this should be our heater. Set that aside. See what it says. English side. Ration heater. Tear the flameless ration heater bag open where indicated and add water to the indicated fill line, approximately 60 milliliters. The fill line is way down at the bottom here, guys, so yeah, it doesn't take much. Lay the heater bag down immediately. Place the food pouch widthwise in the bottom. Hold over the top portion and add a weight on it. Get the knife out of the way so we don't puncture our food bag. That would be bad. This is my filtered river water. God, it's hard to figure out where the fill line is. I'd say we hit it. There we go. I may set my towel over that and we'll see how well that works. Well guys, it's been about 12 minutes. We're gonna give this a go. I wrapped it in just my camp towel and holy heck, that is hot. Ouch. The gloves to handle this thing. I don't think we're gonna have any problem with this, so I'm gonna do a reposition of the camera and let's eat. Let's give this a go. See what we've got here. I can tell you we've got one hell of a pair of hot packages. And I just spilled the heater stuff over to me. That was smooth. Let's start with the soup. Guys, I have to say already, this is a success, other than some minor spillage. Which is probably not the best to have on your skin, but hey, what are you gonna do? It's got a tear spot here, but I don't know how that's gonna open. It looks like kind of opened right. Not real good. I think they designed that to be drained into a bowl. We're not using a bowl today. Guys, this is hot. Really, really, really hot. Looks pretty good. Looks like potato cheesy soup. Guys, that's delicious. My goodness. That is far beyond any of my expectations. Big potato-y chunks. Super tasty. Two thumbs up to Meal Kit Supply Canada. Good job, guys. Guys, I'm really impressed with this. I'm still not sure whether I'd bring these along on very many camps. They're just too heavy. But all things considered, that is a meal fit for a king. Let's try the sausage penne stuff. See how we make out with that. Guys, you can't have your Leatherman too sharp. You gotta have a Leatherman. If you don't have one, get one. You'll never regret it. They're made. I've toured the Leatherman factory twice in Portland, Oregon, and picked up some supplies there. And they're an excellent company to deal with. So, what we've got now is noodles, meat. You can actually see the beef in there. As expected, that's amazing, guys. That beats the pants off of a dehydrated meal any day, but you've got to put up with the weight. I was going to bring some hot sauce with me, but I didn't. There's no need for it in this. That is spicy. Super duper spicy, super duper good. Man. I don't know what you get for weight here, but it's more than I'll eat. Had a late lunch today. Definitely not going to need all this. So, this is more than ample for my supper and a snack, probably, if I can safely store this for a little while. Guys, meal kit supply, meal ready to eat. With the pre-made heater. Two thumbs up, guys. I would definitely, I'd appreciate this in any kind of emergency kit. My vehicle, for probably, except for, not sure how it would react to being frozen. But I keep them at home in a temperature-controlled environment. Man, if we had a situation where I needed, where I couldn't cook a decent meal for whatever reason. I do keep a couple of these in some of my spare backpacks kind of an emergency intention. I'd be plenty happy with this. This is a stellar meal, guys. Well, against my better judgment, I set up the campfire upwind of my camp behind the camera. Turns out there was a downwind. There's a piper of some sort has a nest, and she was getting pretty distressed by me being over there. So I set up here, and it turns out the wind switched, and now the wind's coming away from the camp. So funny how nature has a way of showing us the way. Anyway, thought I'd share that. We're going to set up a fire here. This is going to be what I call my trail fire. I'm by no means an expert, but I know my way around making a fire. It's going to be really small, lots of small twigs that I showed earlier. No need to keep it big. This is just for my enjoyment. I'm not cooking on it. I'm not doing anything with it. So we'll go ahead and get it going. I did cheat and brought some notepaper with me today. So, hey, why not? Let's use it. Just like that, guys, got a fire. Pretty straightforward, nice and warm. I'm good to go for the night, guys. Let's enjoy. Oh, guys, I don't know what to say. Closing out a beautiful day. Got a fire going. Beautiful scenery. The river, the sound of the river is just awesome. Got the radio on now. Just tuned to the local FM station. Nothing too crazy. Maybe I'll tune in some shortwave in a bit. But for now, I think I'm just going to enjoy the ambience. Guys, if you get the chance to get out, go out and enjoy nature whenever you can. It's one of the few privileges that we have that doesn't ask for anything back. You just gotta go out and do it. So, have yourself a small fire. I made a bit of a mistake. I made the fire right on the bedrock, and I don't normally do that. What I usually do, guys, is I find stones like this, and I lay them down. And that way, when you have the fire on them, you can simply take them and wash them down the next day, or give them a little scrub, and when you leave, you can put them over. I practice no trace camping. There won't be anything left behind here, and when I leave, you won't be able to tell I've been here. The mistake with the fire just cost me more time in the morning when I've got to scrub down that bedrock and make it look presentable again. A little anal, I know, but guys, try and leave nature the way you found it whenever possible. It's really nice if someone could camp in this spot tomorrow and not know that I was here the night before. It really lets everyone enjoy things. I packed up a bunch of litter I found over there. Gathered up a bunch more firewood. It's all, like you see, in the fire here now. It's all just deadfall. Really small stuff. It's a real pain in the butt to make a fire on these with the small twigs and stuff. Because you gotta keep heating it constantly. But you can keep it real small, real enjoyable. No need for anything too crazy. Clean up after is a cinch. It's another way to enjoy it. Guys, I'm really glad you could join me on this trip. Truly enjoying this, videoing it with the GoPros. Tomorrow morning, I'll introduce you to the stoves I brought with me. Some are made by me. Of course, we've got to have a DIY segment for this show. But, we'll make some coffee, maybe some noodles for brunch. I don't know. I'll take you through some of that, and if you're interested, I'll show you how to make the ultralight alcohol backpacking stoves that I use. They're super easy. It'll take you like 10 minutes to make one. Nothing to it. And you don't need the fire to cook. You can just cook on your alcohol stoves and enjoy things. So. Well, I figured it wouldn't be my channel unless I do something radio. I thought I'd maybe give it a try on the shortwave now. I think the band's opening up, so let's give it a go here with our under $10 KD radio. Scroll down, make sure we start from the bottom, and let's just see what we get. The slot machine. Maybe give it an excessive volume. Reception is incredible on these things, guys. For what you pay for them, can't really go wrong. I'm just going to pan up quickly so you can hear maybe how many stations I have to choose from. Of course, there is the amateur driver. Yeah. Well, guys, you get the idea. There's tons to choose from. No shortage of stations we can get. I'm going to tune around the band a little bit here and maybe just see what I can find. Reception's really good tonight. Guys, I'm down in a hole in a river valley with just the extendable antenna. No long wire, no nothing. These things just work great. If you just needed to keep an eye on what's going on in the world or wanted to listen to any number of shortwave stations, works pretty good. You get what you pay for. Actually, no, you get much more than what you pay for. I have to say, can't fail with these. I'm going to enjoy it. I'm going to have another drink, sit by the fire, stoke up the fire, and just enjoy the sunset, guys. Really glad you could join me.
Well, guys, it's morning. I think it's about 7 o'clock, almost on the nose. First order of business is to get some coffee on the go. So this is the GSI Pinnacle Duelist kit. This kit, put in it is some items that are not very standard. These are my homemade stoves. If you guys are interested, I'll show you guys how to make these. It's really, really easy. But let's just get this set up. We'll get some water on the go. Well, guys, I think that's about it. Just sitting here on the shore, enjoying my coffee. I think I'm going to pack up and head out here soon. Going to have to take everything home and dry it out. I don't have enough time to stay here and let the tent dry out. Had a pretty heavy dew last night. Everything's a little damp. So I'll take it home, hang it up on the clothesline outside today, and clean everything up and repack it in case I want to use it again this weekend. I'm off for a few days, so really glad you guys could join me on this trip. Hope I get to take you along again soon. If you enjoyed this video, please consider hitting the thumbs up button down below. Really appreciate it, guys. Hopefully I can make a little bit of a series of some outdoor videos for you guys and some of the DIY gear. I'm not going to get to show you the other stove because I'm not going to take the time to stay and do lunch. I think it's time to head out, guys. Cheers.